Hello everyone, welcome to the first episode of FS Brew, where we talk about interesting news, events and products from the world of insurance and financial services.
Each of us have picked the few latest news and developments which we felt were interesting. I hope you will enjoy listening to our take on this. As a background, I'm a startup advisor and I work as the business development head for an insurtech based out of Singapore called Simbo.
And as a background, I am the founder of Forward. Forward is a startup that works with insurance companies to accelerate their digital marketing and digital transformation initiatives. So here we go with our first episode.
So the first thing that caught my attention in the last few weeks is about Google offering a cyber insurance program for its Google Cloud customers, and got this off siliconangle.com. And the news quote says that Google has partnered with Allianz SE's corporate insurance unit and Munich Re Group, and the firms will provide specialized and enhanced cyber insurance designed exclusively for Google Cloud customers. At the moment, this is a small foray into insurance, and this is what the insurance companies feared. What will happen if tech gets into their domain? And Google has a good success story in the financial services space in terms of wallets in India and in the US with their Google Pay offering. So the question is, can they do something big here as well? And taking it on from a corporate setting to a personal line setting, with the amount of information that they have on us, can they create targeted insurance programs that are very good for, let's say, health insurance or for general protection? What do you think?
No, that sounds very interesting, and it's also potentially disruptive as well. And it looks like they've taken like the first and sort of the most common step that they should be from an insurance perspective. It'll be interesting to see how they actually expand, like you said, into the personal space, especially because they have such a micro level of information about us. It'll be exciting how they come up with sort of, you know, product proposition and the whole distribution piece as well. So it's a wait and watch, especially for the Middle East market, and see how they go about actually launching that here.
Yeah, no, that's a good point that you raised here. And the important thing to ask is, can some of the forward-looking insurers take the first step and connect with Google and say, hey, I want to be a fronting insurer in this region?
Yeah, nobody wants to compete with them, no? You'd rather partner with them.
Absolutely.
Great. So, you know, one of the local news that I thought was pretty good and very interesting was Access Motor campaign, an online campaign that they have launched, I think, about a month or so. And I just found the entire whole, you know, customer experience pretty seamless and really well executed. So as a marketer, I quite enjoyed that whole, experience. It was clean execution. They had clear messages, advantages of why they should be buying car insurance from AXA. So they had a good hook, which was, I think you get up to 50% safe driver discount if you buy insurance with them. So I took a quote, I checked out their experience, and, you know, it real time tells you the discount that you earn as a customer. So it felt pretty transparent and safe. And generally the ease and the speed with which they did it was very commendable. So I thought it was a very well executed campaign overall. Ranjit, did you have a chance to have a, you know, look at it?
Yes, I did after you pointed it out. And I was just wondering, you know, the discount offer, it's pretty hefty and
pretty substantial. And
passing through Sheikh Zayed Road, you see that big advertisement by Policy Bazaar. Right. And surprisingly, they are also offering that 50%. So I wonder if this is something as a competitive response to Policy Bazaar. So.
It's a good point there, because there's a lot going on in the market from a discount perspective. There's also another insurer doing a 30% discount. So I think it is getting into that sort of discount game, and each one is trying to give their sort of proposition as to why there's this cleaner, better, more value for money. But that's a good point. But from an AXA perspective, I thought it was just generally a clean executed one. It was not confusing. Even when you land there, it's not confusing. I got a 45% discount straight away, and I could see where is my savings. So I quite enjoyed the whole process. It felt, you know, pretty good. It wasn't dubious, which is what, you know, as a customer we want. So well done to them.
Yeah, absolutely. So it's up to 50%. So it's not a straight 50% then. Okay.
Yes. Yeah. So it's really up to your, the years that you have had no accident and a combination of other underwriting parameters, which will give you a real-time discount. So based on my parameters, I got a 45% discount, which is pretty neat.
Right.
So
I'm not sure I'll get that discount given my parameters, but
I sort of cheated, you know, so I don't even have a driving license. So I sort of cheated to see how the whole process is. Okay.
That was a good local piece of news, and it had a bearing on the motor insurance industry. And I've got one connected with that. So shall we talk about that?
Yeah, sure.
So this is from the MEinsurancereview.com. And they're talking about the Emirates Insurance Association that has confirmed that it's presenting a proposal for an electric link between insurance companies and vehicle licensing authorities so as to enhance traffic safety. So, if you remember, we've had many of these proposals in the past where we wanted to have a sort of claims database or an accident database so that insurance companies can correctly price the risk. So I think this is a good step in the right direction. It's not been implemented yet. So it's a wait and watch for when this will happen. We have some private companies operating in this space, as you know, Vidya, like Autodata. But no such, sort of joint initiative with all the RTAs from the seven Emirates. It will definitely have a big impact on bringing claims costs down by checking frauds and pre-existing damages before, insuring. What do you think?
No, it makes sense. And I'm also thinking from a customer experience perspective. So imagine, from a customer point, you don't have to upload many of the information or, type it all out on the website or on your mobiles or whatever that is. And it's just with just few parameters, it's able to pull out everything for the customer. So imagine the ability to issue a quote or a policy reduces dramatically for an insurer. So that means a happy customer. So it's generally, it serves very well from a customer experience perspective as well.
Yeah, absolutely. That's a good point that you brought up about customer experience. I was talking from the insurer's side.
That's fine. So by virtue of, as a marketer and what we do, I guess just thought went there. I think you've dabbled with that as well. And I've dabbled with that as well for some of our clients. How do we make it quite easy as a process when it comes to online journey? Because many of us find it quite boring, and especially when you have to purchase insurance, it is pretty boring. So you want to get it done quite quickly. So hopefully something like this just, fastens the whole process for a customer.
Yeah, no, absolutely. If you can pre-populate the vehicle details as much as possible and the claims history, then you just cut down the number of fields. I recall going through an international insurer that I would not name had about, 40 to 50 fields that you have to fill online to get a quote. And for me, that is the difference between digitization and digitalization. Just don't put up your application form on the web. You've got to do far more than that to make the journey easier, as you said.
Yes. Absolutely. And that's one of the biggest pain points for any insurance companies. The bounce rate is so high because the customer is just, intimidated by the quantum of information they have to produce for just getting one motor insurance. So this hopefully comes through quite quickly and just helps the ecosystem.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Go.
Great. Thanks, Ranjit. So I think carrying on from, the whole motor industry itself, there's one more from a very marketing angle I've picked up. It's a very interesting search activity led predominantly by none other than insurance market. So they have created this many shadow websites. They have things like carinsurance.ee, protectmycar.ee, zoompolicy.com, and so on and so forth. So if you go to any of these websites, you will notice at the bottom of these websites, they're referring to as products of insurancemarket.ee. So this, as you know, is a trend commonly used by many retailers to have strong backlinks and to strengthen their website domain authority, essentially looking good in the eyes of Google. But what's interesting is it was just insurance market that had picked up this trend from another sort of industry and a sector, use that for themselves. Of course, there's a lot of parameters that works in to make sure that authority increases, because all of those shadow websites should also have strong domain authority for ultimately insurance market to benefit from. So there's a lot to watch in that space. But I just found that whole thing interesting because they've picked it up from in another sector. And then I think recently Cosmos is doing that as well. I saw their pitstoparabia.com or something that's come up as well. It was good of them to pick up new initiatives across other industries and lead that for the insurance sector.
And you can see that insurance market has a pretty good track record of innovating over the last 10 years, and they are, I think, and they are leading in terms of valuations as well, right? In terms of the insurtech space, if I'm not wrong. We'll fish out the exact valuation in the next episode. Interesting that they're using some of these, I don't want to call it tricks, but growth hacking kind of techniques.
They're massively into that whole growth hacking, but good point there. Massively into that. And I think they've generally been market leading when it comes to a lot of these initiatives, whether getting into radio and literally hijacking the whole radio spots across, and then just outdoor. And, so they've just been understanding the power of marketing, which is what I like about that brand. You know, it can really tell you what a power of marketing can do for what seemed like a startup, although they are not. They are a well-established broker-led company, but insurancemarket.ee is a fairly new brand. It's, I think, about 10 or 15-year-old brand. So for them to now be at the very top of their game, they've really embraced a lot of new initiatives.
It makes a lot of sense, especially since Policy Bazaar is coming into their market with a $75 million raise to enter the Middle East. So they have to be pretty innovative to tackle that
trend. So if somebody came to Dubai, they'll only be seeing insurance holdings across the city. Because that's what the game would be, I
think. Absolutely. That's a very interesting piece of news, Vidya.
Thank you.
We hope you enjoyed our first episode. A little grainy, a few shaky angles, but with a whole lot of promise and potential to come.
Please like, comment, and share this video if you liked our episode. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for the latest episode. Also follow FS Brew LinkedIn page to stay updated for more such episodes to come. See you soon.
See you.